Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Today I created this bomb ombre pink purple smoky look. I've been really into the pinks and the purples lately. If you guys want to know how to achieve this look, just keep on watching.
Tell me what you want. Tell me what you want. Tell me what you want. Tell me what you want.
Okay guys, hey, so getting right into the video, I'm starting off by priming my eyelids using the Makeup Revolution concealer and I believe the shade C1, and I'm gonna buff that out using one of my Real Techniques brushes. So once I finish buffing out the concealer, I'm going straight in and I'm packing on my crease color. Now I'm going to just continue to pack this on because I really want this color to pop in my crease. It's going to be like my base color for my crease because I'm creating an ombre look. So I really want it to fade from dark to light. So as you can see, I'm just packing that on and I'm going to go ahead and blend out the edges of that using a lighter pink shade. I'm gonna buff out those edges to my liking, and then I'm also gonna go in using a clean Morphe M506 brush with some translucent powder to clean up the edges of that transition shade. That way it can just fade from light to dark very smoothly. And then I wanna go back into my crease using that same deep shade that I was packing on into my crease just to deepen up that color a little bit more. And I'm also going to go in with a deep purple to make it just a little bit darker because I didn't like the way that the original pink shade was looking. I wanted it to be even more deeper into my crease. So I just packed on a purple, like a deep rooted purple into my crease. That way I can get that effect that I was going for. Okay, now, so I'm going to take that same concealer that I used to prime my lids by Makeup Revolution. I'm going to pack that on. I'm not going to create a cut crease, but I just wanted to create the shape first, and then I'm going to buff and blend that color out. That way, it won't be such a harsh line, because you do not want to create a harsh line like you're creating a cut crease. That way, it can really transition from dark to light on the lid smoothly. So, after I finish buffing on that concealer on my lids, I'm gonna go in with a bright pink shade and just pack that onto my lids really nicely, just to set that concealer. This pink shade that I'm packing onto my lid is also the shade that I use to go ahead and blend out the edges of that crease color, just to make you guys aware of that as well, because you're kind of transitioning from each color. That way you can create the effect of an ombre lid. So here I'm going back into my crease using that same deep pink shade just to create that ombre effect with the transition of the colors. And then you're also going to see me go back into that deep purple to deepen up my crease just a little bit more. That way I can get the effect that I was going for. And I'm also going to pack that onto the edge of my lid. So the key to ombre lid is blending. You want to make sure you're blending out your shadows really, really well. So you're going to see me pack on here a brighter pink shadow that I wanted to be I wanted that little pop on my lid. So I had to add a brighter pink eyeshadow to get the effect that I really, really wanted to show the transition between the colors. But you want to really, really make sure that you're blending everything out. Take your time to blend all of your eyeshadows out to your liking. That way you can get that nice smooth effect and transition between the shades. So now I'm going to go in with my regular black liner. And I use liner from Sephora. I love their liner. It's really, really good and is matte, which I love. I love a matte black liner. And I'm not going to create a wing liner, but I just want to line the top of my lid. And I'm going to line just the edge of my lid. And I'm going to pack on a little bit of that deep purple and black. That way you can get that nice, smooth, smoky ombre effect and transition between the colors. And that way you want to see the edge of the liner on my lid. I Okay, so now that I'm done blending out my eyeshadows, I'm gonna go in and put some mascara on my lashes. And now I'm gonna go ahead and pop on some falsies. You know I love my falsies. Perfect, cute, go ahead girl. So I'm going straight into the face. I'm using my matte primer by Huda Beauty, as usual. One of my favorite primers. It lasts all day and it keeps my makeup intact. Now I'm going in with my deep translucent powder by Laura Mercier, and I'm putting that all in my T-zone where I get oily the most, because it helps control my oils throughout the day. And now I'm using my Juvia's Place foundation in the shade 320, I believe. Yeah, I believe it's 320. Okay, so I only use a little bit of foundation because this foundation can get really muddy and it can just be too much. So you just want to use a little bit, because literally a little bit goes a long way. And when I spray my sediments over my face, it helps blend it out very seamlessly for me, which I love. And now that I'm blending that out with my brush, I'm also going to go in with my Beauty Real Technique sponge to blend out the edges of that foundation. That way I get a smooth transition from my face, so I don't, like, I got a mask on. You know how some people blend out their foundation but doesn't blend out the edges and looks like you have a mask on? That's one thing that I hate. So I make sure I blend. Blending is key with everything in regards to makeup and my. So now that we're done blending out that foundation, I'm going to go in with my ColourPop concealer in the shade 42. And I'm going to put that all under my eyelids, down the bridge of my nose, my cupid's bow, and my chin, and a little bit on my forehead. I don't like to put a lot of concealer on my forehead because I don't like that big brightening effect. I already got a big forehead, so I like to bronze a lot. That way I can make my forehead appear smaller, of course. So I'm gonna go ahead and blend out my concealer with my Real Techniques beauty sponge, and I just love the way this concealer blends out. It blends out really flawless to me, and it lasts me all day, and it's really matte because I have oily skin, which I love. I love mattifying concealers, but it's not too matte where it's drying. It's just the right enough touch. It's like a soft matte in my opinion, which I really like about concealers, because I don't like anything that's too drying and it's too tough to blend out. So I'm blending that out, and now I'm going to go in with my foundation stick by Anastasia Beverly Hills in the shade Ebony, and I'm going to use this to contour my face. And before I actually blend out that foundation stick, I'm going to blend out the concealer on the bridge of my nose. Now I'm just going to go ahead and blend out my contour on my cheekbones and my forehead. And you just want to make sure you're really paying attention to how you blend this, because you don't want to blend it too low. And you also don't want to blend it too high when it takes up most of your highlight underneath your eyes. So just pay attention to how you're blending. Blend in kind of like an upward motion, but patting. Don't swipe, but pat. You see me patting a lot. That's because that's how you get a more seamless blend, in my opinion. That's just what works for me. Okay, so now we're gonna get into this nose contour. So I like to contour my nose by putting two little small lines on the side of my nose and also underneath my brows. I like to blend it up and give it that nice little shape. So I'm gonna use a tiny small fluffy brush, and I'm gonna blend out my nose contour, and I use that same foundation stick that I use to contour my face. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with my Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'm going to set my under eye, and I just like to pat that in, and I'm also going to shape my nose contour with the translucent powder as well, as you can see. And I'm just going to leave that and let it sit for a little bit, but I'm going to pack the rest of the translucent powder all over my face. And any excess powder that's on my face, I'm going to use one of my big fluffy brushes and just buff that away smoothly. When you buff away the foundation, you kind of want to pat it into your skin, but swipe at the same time, if you get what I'm saying. So you just look at the motions that I'm doing. I will swipe away my forehead, but I will underneath my eye pat it a little bit. That way you can really, really set that under eye. Now I'm going in and bronzing my face. I love to bronze my face, as I say all the time. I'm using my Anastasia Beverly Hills bronzer in the shade Mahogany, and I just love bronzer because it just gives you that, I don't know, it gives you, not like how contour can be a bit harsh, but it gives you that nice, like you just came from a trip and you were in the sun and you just got that nice little glow to you. I don't know. I just love bronzer. So now I'm going in with my Milani blush in a highlight by ColourPop. I'm not sure what shade highlight this is, but I'm going to leave it in the description box for you guys. And I used two highlights. I kind of do that all the time. I'm going to go back in with another highlight by Anastasia Beverly Hills in the Glow Kit. And I'm going to use the shade Bronze. Now to finish my contour on my nose, I'm going to go in with that bronzer. And I'm going to make sure I like really, really contour my nose with that. And if it looks too harsh, I might go back in and pat around my nose using the excess powder that's on that fluffy brush that I used earlier. So now we're gonna throw on some brow gel, and I'm using the L'Oreal brow gel in the shade clear, and put that on my brow so my brow hairs can stay intact all day. So now that I'm done with my face, I'm gonna go in and set the rest of my face with my Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. Basically drowning myself in it and fanning myself with one of my eyeshadow palettes as usual. Need to buy a fair for Amazon. I don't know what I'm waiting for. But anyway, I'm going to go in underneath my waterline and place the same colors that I placed in my crease and put those underneath the waterline. And because I wasn't satisfied with the pink shimmer shade I put in my tear ducts, I used my NYX glitter liner just to give myself a little bit of pop in my inner tear ducts. Now I'm going to go in with my nude liner by L'Oreal, and I'm gonna place that in my waterline. So now I'm going in and just putting some mascara on my bottom lashes, of course, because we like those to pop out as well. And I always put my mascara on after I use my Morphe Setting Mist. So now I'm gonna put on some of my NYX Butter Gloss in a pink shade, and then I'm gonna go in with one of my lip liners in the shade Coco, and I'm gonna line my lips with that just to give a nice effect. I didn't want to use a liquid lipstick, so I just use my lip liner, and then I put lip gloss on. I just love the way what this does to my look. I don't always use a liquid lipstick and then put on gloss and all that. I just sometimes use a lip liner, put some gloss on, and bam, I'm done. So this is pretty much the finished look. If you guys like the video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and share the video, please. And I hope to see you guys in the next one. Please leave me some suggestions down in the link below. And thank you guys for watching. Love you guys. Bye.